And for about the first and the last, I quote. I quote from page 14 of the document. Enumerative reasoning is all right as far as it goes, but as we are rather slow-witted, it doesn't go very far. Enumerative reasoning is only an adequate mental tool under the severe boundary condition that we only use it very moderately. We should appreciate abstraction as our main mental technique to reduce the demands made upon enumerative reasoning. I had had two external stimuli. In 1968, a NATO conference in Garmisch-Partenkirchen on software engineering, and the founding of the IFIP Working Group on Programming Method, WG 2.3 on Programming Methodology. I remember the Garmisch-Partenkirchen conference organized by F.L. Bauer as one of the most exciting moments in my life. I had been waiting for that for at least 5 and perhaps 10 years. Because this was the first time that I noticed a large group of people from all sorts of places, each of them so high in their local hierarchy that they could afford to be honest. And at last it was openly admitted that programming was very difficult. And that, of course, was a condition that something, to get activity, that something would be done about it. Yeah, thanks to the ubiquitous Xerox machine, my typewritten text could spread like wildfire. And it did so probably because people found it refreshing in the prevailing culture characterized by the 1968 IBM advertisement in Datamation. I don't think you remember it, but that advertisement presented in full color a beaming Susie Meyer, who had solved all her programming problems, quote, by switching to PL1, unquote. Apparently, IBM did not like the popularity of my text. It stole the term structured programming and, under auspices of Harlan D. Mills, trivialized the original concept to the abolishment of the go-to statement. Looking back, I cannot fail to observe my fear of formal mathematics at the time. In 1970, I had spent more than a decade hoping and then arguing that programming would be and should become a mathematical activity. I had rearranged the programming task so as to make it better amenable to mathematical treatment, but carefully avoided creating the required mathematics myself. I had to wait for Bob Floyd, who laid the foundation, for Jim King, who showed me the first example that convinced me, and for Tony Hoare, who showed how semantics could be defined in terms of axioms needed for the proofs of properties of programs. And then I didn't see the significance of their work immediately. I was really slow. Okay, finally a short story for the record. In 1968, the Communications of the ACM published a text of mine under the title The Go-To Statement Considered Harmful, which in later years would be the most frequently referenced, regret, yeah? Regrettably, however, often by authors who had seen no more than its title. The title became a cornerstone of my fame, by becoming a template, we could see all sorts of articles under the title X considered harmful for almost any X, including one titled Dextra considered harmful. But what had happened? I had submitted a paper under the title A Case Against the Goto Statement. And assume it was written under the assumption that everybody knew that the Goto Statement was a combinatorial complexity generator. I had, among others, said so in 1965 at the IFA conference in New York. Even then, I didn't expect the thing to be new. But the point of the paper is the explanation why it creates complexity. So that was the case against the go-to statement. The paper, which in order to speed up its publication, the editor had changed into a letter to the editor. And in the process, he had given it a new title of his own invention. The editor was Niklaus Wirth.